Hey guys, it's JP, and today we're going to take a look at ways to work on the soleus that are easy to implement at home. Now, the reason I want to make this video is because strength training is an important component in running, as well as just life in general, as it has a number of benefits. However, it may be tough to do during this time as gyms seem to be closing again. That's why for these next few weeks, I will go over exercises that are easy to implement at home. This time, I'm going to start this series with my favorite muscle for runners, which is the soleus. This muscle is part of the calf muscle complex and is heavily involved in running. As I have mentioned previously, this muscle may develop forces around 6 to 8 times your body weight. However, to bias this specific muscle, you basically need to engage the calf muscle in a bent knee position. Now that we talked about that, let's go over some exercises you can try at home to work the soleus. The first exercise we will go over is the soleus wall sit. The reason I wanted to feature this one here is because you don't need any weights. All you really need is a wall. This is also a simple way to engage not only the soleus, but also the quads, which is an important muscle to work on as well. Now to do this one, find an empty wall and pretend like you are sitting in a chair. Then, as you can see, lift the heels 1 to 2 inches high. By doing so, this works the calf muscle in around 10 degrees of ankle plantar flexion, which is basically when the foot moves away from the body. This range may be particularly important as peak force of these muscles is seen around this range as you run. I incorporate this detail for runners to improve specificity to running and hopefully improve carryover to it. When starting this exercise, I typically start people by having them hold this position for 20 seconds, 3 times. Also, you can make it harder by simply placing more weight on your lap. Now, if you want to challenge yourself more, you can try the soleus wall sit with heel taps. This is a progression of the previous exercise. This further challenges this area, as now you're going to have to support yourself on one leg versus two. The same rules basically apply here, such as pretending like you are sitting in a chair, as well as only lifting the heels 1 to 2 inches high. When doing this one, it is a gentle tap of the heel on the floor in front of you. Now, when I have people doing this one, I typically start them by performing 20 heel taps with 1 second holds for 3 sets. Similar to the last one, you can further challenge yourself by putting weight on your lap, or you can just hold the foot out longer. Now, another exercise you can try is the standing soleus heel raise. Instead of doing the standard seated heel raise, you can try this one. The difference with this one is that by working the leg in an elevated position, this allows you to bend the ankle more, specifically go into a more dorsiflex position. This can be important considering that peak force of the calf has shown to be generated around 10 to 15 degrees of ankle dorsiflexion to about 10 degrees of plantar flexion, as I mentioned earlier. When doing this one, try to keep the shin vertical to really focus on working the soleus muscle. I typically have people start this by safely placing a 15-pound object on the front part of the thigh and perform this for 3 sets of 10 repetitions. To further challenge yourself, you can always incorporate more weight, or you can change the tempo and increase difficulty by increasing speed as it goes up and slow down the speed as the heel descends. And those are some simple exercises to try at home. I hope you guys found this useful. I'd love to hear your thoughts as well as any questions you may have. And as always, thank you for watching.